Good morning. The hill behind me there is called Granite Mountain. Probably one of 20 of the name. This is the one in the Eagletail Wilderness area. And I'm going to pause for a moment and talk about an anime. Area 88. There are two Area 88 animes, both telling the same war story based on the same manga. The first was released back in 1985 in Japan as a three-act OVA. That was in the dawn of the direct-to-video market with Laserdiscs and VHS. It was released in the North American market by USMC back in the 90s. The more recent version is a 12-part TV series released in 2004 in Japan and more recently by ADV Films in the North American market. ADV Films also picked up the original OVA series and redubbed it with the same cast for North American release as well. Let's take a quick look at the plot. Area 88 is a war story set at a fictitious airbase called Area 88 in the fictitious nation of Aslan, which is located somewhere in the Middle East or North Africa.
It's set out in the desert in the middle of nowhere. What kind of a lame location is that for a video?
Hello!
All the pilots stationed at Area 8 are mercenaries there for the money. They're a multinational group of misfits, and they're each there for their own reasons, a sort of aerial foreign legion. The lead character is Shin Kazuma, and we'll explore his reason for being there in more detail. He's the lone Japanese at the base, and he's a hotshot pilot. Shin didn't start out to be a fighter pilot. He wanted to be a commercial airline pilot. We'll explore in flashbacks how he actually got to Area 88. He and his comrades are all signed up for a 3-year stint, or until they can make enough money to pay off a huge penalty clause on their contract. They get paid for each kill and each mission, and they have to pay for their own ammo and maintenance from there. The story begins when a photographer, also Japanese, arrives at the airbase. The photographer is one of the few characters who changes name between the two versions of the anime, and he also has a slightly different story in each. He takes a special interest in Shin, perhaps because they're both Japanese, or perhaps he has other reasons. Either way, he'll be instrumental in revealing Shin's background story.
I'll bet you're Shin Kazuma, aren't you? Nice to finally meet you. I've heard quite a lot of rumors about you, that there was a lone Japanese pilot in the skies above the Kingdom of Aslan.
Some kind of combat photographer?
The commander of Area 88 is Saki, and he's one of the few characters who's actually an Aslan national. In the original OVA, we explore his reasons for participating in Aslan's war in a little more detail. He's largely just the command figure in the TV series. There are several other pilots who appear in both versions of the anime. Shin's friend Mickey is probably the most significant. The other notable denizen of Area 88 is Old Man McCoy, a scrounger and supply dealer who can get you just about anything you might want for the right price. The story in Area 88 centers on the pilots and Shin in particular, and the missions they're asked to fly, and their activities on the airbase in between. We'll also get to explore a lot of Shin's backstory. Each of the pilots at Area 88 has their own aircraft type, and because of that, the airbase almost seems to be a fighter museum. That's probably because the manga's author, Kaoru Shintani, is a big air buff. There'll be a lot of episodic combat missions where the pilots are asked to fly specific tasks.
I got the lead MiGs.
Yeah, you take the easy ones.
It isn't all about flashy aerial combat, though. The original OVA brought Shin's box story up to the beginning of the story and put it front and center, whereas the TV series holds off until episode 6 or 7 before it begins to get into it. Shin left a girl, Ryoko, back home, and he's dying to get back to her. Meanwhile, his best friend back home, Kanzaki, is trying to put the moves on his girl. Since both the original OVA and the newer TV series tell the same story, most people will be satisfied with watching one or the other. The original OVA series, as three acts, ran about a total of 3 hours, whereas the newer TV series, as 12 episodes, ignoring the duplicate opening and closings, runs about 4 hours of story total. It gets to spend a little more time telling the story and adds a few more combat missions and characters. There are some differences in the supporting cast between the two versions of the anime, perhaps just adapting the cast to the time period it's in. The original OVA was made less than 10 years after the Vietnam War, and so it includes, for example, some Vietnamese pilot veterans, and one character who's actually a Vietnamese pilot. I love his cravat and the tiger-striped flight suit. The original OVA also has a trio of mercenaries from a Central African war. They specialize in hunting down would-be deserters. The newer OVA series gives Shin a turban-wearing friend, Kim, who flies a Harrier jump jet. And somewhere around episode 5, the newer series sends in a gorgeous female pilot, Kitri, who's the only female pilot on the base. You're probably thinking that the newer series using computer-assisted animation has the edge in the aerial combat sequences, but I'm not so sure. And I'm not just saying that because I'm old. The original OVA series used some spectacular hand-drawn animation to illustrate the aerial combat sequences. I showed a clip from the TV series earlier, so I'm going to show you one from the original OVA series now. As I said, I think the original OVA's animation holds up really well today. Since the two stories both tell pretty much the same set of combat missions, it's in how they tell the story that the two distinguish themselves, and even there isn't a lot of difference. As I said before, the original OVA brings Shin's background story up a lot earlier, whereas the TV series holds off on it a bit. Also, Ryoko has a stronger role in the OVA series.
Where? Here. Look! Right here! It's too small for me to say for sure, but...
Shin's still out there. He's still alive!
Photos by Rocky.
I wonder if he's talked to Shin.
The publisher is World Press.
I'll call them. Please take care of things at the party.
The original OVA series gave us, through the commander, Saki, a little more information about the nature of the conflict in Aslan that they're fighting in. However, we don't learn enough about it to really want to take a side either way, and the mercenaries of Area 88 are motivated by money and other factors, not by the politics of Aslan. Shin's character in the original OVA is perhaps a little weaker in terms of personality. In the TV series, he's got more of the right stuff attitude, and by that I mean the Tom Wolfe book, not the anime store. The two anime differ slightly in the way they get to the ending. The original took us to Paris for some revealing character moments that I really enjoyed. But either way, we get to the same point at the ending, so I'm not sure there's a big difference there. So in conclusion, I'm not sure which one I'd care to recommend. Interestingly, when ADV Films picked up the TV series, they also picked up the original OVA series, and they redubbed it using the voice cast that they used for the TV series, which gives them an interesting consistency, and also means that the original OVA series sounds like a much more modern US dub production, rather than some of the old clunkers you may be thinking of. I highly recommend you watch Area 88, and I guess I would prefer the original OVA, but if you're a more modern guy, the TV series is just fine. The one knock on it is that it doesn't use the animation in a way that would really distinguish it from a live-action Hollywood film, maybe a Top Gun, for example. On the whole, I give either of the OVAs a 4.5-star rating, and I suggest you watch one or the other. If you really like the one, you may want to go back and watch the other just to see what you missed.
Thanks for listening.